came from the mud. There's dirt on my hands. Strong like a tree. There's roots where I stand. Oh, I've been running from the law.
Everybody, I hope you had an amazing holiday. I hope you got to spend time with family and friends and get out and do some things that you enjoy. I know I work in law enforcement, so sometimes it's touch and go with scenarios like that, but I've been thankful that no call outs or anything, so I've been able to actually go out of town and spend some time with my wife's family in Aberdeen, North Carolina. It's down near Southern Pines, so it would be central North Carolina. I live in western North Carolina up in Boone. My wife, she's from Southern Pines, so we're able to go down there, and that is why you're seeing some different scenery, as you can tell from the intro there, than what we normally have on our channel, what we normally can show here. Most of the time it's here locally in Boone, but we're able to get out of town for a bit. And consequently, we're able to do some pretty neat challenges, pretty neat testing, if you will, with the Scotty-O. What you're seeing here, the only thing that I used for this video is the Scotty-O 2 and the Osmo Pocket. So that was really neat. Now, with the Scotty-O 2, I've got a few notes. With the Scotty-O 2, we shot everything in 4K at 60 frames per second. No filter, and likewise, there's no filter with the Osmo Pocket, and we shot 4K 30 with that. So you'll see a mixture of the two clips, or mixture of video clips from those two devices. So when you look at it, the small form factor between the two, we wanted something small to carry. We were in my wife's car. She drives a Ford Edge, so we're carrying presents down. We're bringing presents back. And so we had to do everything we could to keep everything compact in the vehicle. It was full on the way back. But we had to do everything in a small form factor. So would the Scotty-O 2 be a good everyday carry drone option? Now, for the past year, I've been carrying the Mavic 2 Pro in the case that comes with DJI that you can purchase through DJI and what have you, and the Fly More kit. And so that's a pretty compact form factor. What you're seeing here is just the Scotty-O 2 by itself and the Osmo Pocket by itself as well, and just the two small cases there. So all the flights were done just with my phone. There's no beacon, no controller, anything like that. Only one battery, so it's just the small retail package that you're seeing as far as the Scotty-O is concerned. So we were able to do a couple of different, two or three different testings just to kind of see how it would work out. The first thing we started out with was follow mode with the golf buggy. We'll call it the golf buggy. It's a bad boy buggy. And Josh and I were in the buggy, and I started out on the outside. Josh was on the inside. He was driving for me. Josh is my son, and also he works with me with Jaybird Aerial as well. He's my visual observer, so he's a great help, and I'm thankful for his help with this video. So the first thing that you're going to see here and take note of, it was so-so with the buggy and tracking, because what it was trying to do, the Scotty-O 2 was trying to either connect to track Josh, connect to him, or connect to me. And we were also able to get it to connect to the buggy just kind of momentarily. It did not stay connected to it so well there at the beginning, but you'll see it kind of straightened out toward the end. And we were actually doing some of the front-facing videoing as well, not just from behind. I do a lot of, I guess you'd say, tracking or following, but this was actually a little bit from the front as well, so that was kind of neat to see. What you'll also notice when in using my wife's vehicle coming down the driveway to my mother-in-law's farm, it tracks the vehicle wonderfully. You saw probably one of my earlier videos with my truck, and flawlessly, I mean, it was great with that. Again, we're not, you know, going down the road too fast. This was a private drive, so we're probably staying in the 20 to 25 mile per hour range. So Scotty was clocked out at 36, so really wasn't pushing it too hard, but a good steady flow that you can see it going there. So this next video clip here kind of received mixed reviews, again, mostly positive, when I posted it on Facebook, and I just wanted to put it out there kind of as, I guess, a commercial or in preparation for this video here to show all the details of this testing. So, as you can see from the video clips, Southern Pines is a lot different than what you see mostly here in here in Boone or Western North Carolina. It's flatter, and then there were some good open places here. The pine trees that you're seeing here were hand planted by man, or man planted, if you will, in those rows. And so as we were taking my wife's mother's dog for a walk, I saw that and I thought, wow, I wonder. We walked through the woods a couple of times. I was wondering, will the Sky DO2 track this? Will it actually follow me through this? And I was apprehensive at first, but I've seen the obstacle avoidance firsthand and how well it works. So I thought, even if it didn't track me through the tree rows, I felt comfortable enough that it wouldn't crash. So what you'll see is how I'm going through the woods here. And I've received mixed reviews. Some folks were saying it's crazy to even think this drone could do that. But I liken it unto this. If you bought a brand new camera and it was rated for amazing night photography, low light photography or what have you, the first thing that you would do with that camera is take it out at night and see how it would perform. So I do know and understand this is probably definitely an extensive testing here. What you'll see, I actually attempted it for about 2 minutes and 45 seconds. This clip here is only a minute long. But just to give you an idea of how it would do. Now, different people had posted and said maybe if I wore different color clothing that added more contrast, it would be more apt to follow me or track me easier. And others are saying you're not walking fast enough. But what I tried to do, I had my phone in my hand so I could see when connection was lost from the drone to my phone. So what I would do is try to walk at an even pace up until the point I saw where it said connection lost. Then obviously I'd go back to the drone where it could see me and I could actually connect back to it and try that a few times. But I didn't want to crash it. I didn't want to push it too far, try it too long, or push my luck, if you will. But again, I have a lot of confidence in Sky DO, and even though some maybe thought I was trying to make the drone fail, that was not my goal. My goal was, if this drone can track me, follow me through these rows of trees, even though they're not perfectly even rows or anything like that, that would be amazing footage. We are looking for what kind of cinematic footage, many of us are, what kind of cinematic footage can we get with this drone, even in close quarters? That was my hope, because in having just the drone with me, that was a wonderful opportunity to try to test this out and see if it would work or not. So I couldn't wait to get back there, and you'll see, even though it doesn't get all the way through, what you'll notice here is how when I actually take the control over, I get behind the drone and I take control of it with my phone and I fly it out, you'll see it was very successful in doing that. Maybe not perfectly smooth or cinematic, but it is avoiding the obstacles, the trees, as we're going through. So I count it a huge win. And so that's what I was looking at here. I would call this low speed, high impact testing in the woods is kind of what I had called it there. It's not too fast. I was thinking if I was moving very fast, it might get caught up maybe in some of the smaller branches. But you can see some of the small pine needles and those very small things that it picks up and observes and goes by those. So this by no means was a way to try to fail the Sky DO, but to test it. As new technology comes out, I think we are ready to see something different. We've seen several immersive videos. We've seen several aerial videos throughout the past few years. So in looking at this device, I really wanted to see what can I use this for? Can I use this for some of my real estate videos, some of my promotional work where normally it would be a gimbal? Could I actually use it to track someone or do that type of work, even though it's a little bit closer? So this was no by no accounts trying to fail the Sky DO2. Also, if we only post videos that shed a device, any device, in a certain light, if we're only wanting to make it look positive, we could do that. If we only wanted to make it look negative, we could do that. What I'm trying to do on my channel with the accessories, which currently I don't have any, just my phone, I want to see what it's capable of doing. And you can see some of the cinematic shots that we were able to catch with it. So I count it a win. But if we only try to paint one version or one side of the story, we're failing as reviewers. We're failing as sharing information with other owners, other pilots, and other people who are using whatever device that it is. This was mainly to show just a no-nonsense, this is how it performed in these situations. First-hand experience. I know several people are still waiting to receive their drone. This gives us something to do in the meantime. Let you see it and see how it performs. So at no risk to you, you can kind of see how it performed with me. And you can see on the other videos where several have been caught up in smaller branches and what have you. Thankfully, knock on wood, I've not crashed my Skydio yet. So to me, I count that a win. Also, a lot of folks have been saying, well, a Mavic 2 could do this, or some of the other devices, the Mavics could do this. I've never tried that, and I don't know. And respectfully, I don't have enough confidence in my Mavic to try this. So this is a testament to Skydio that I would even be willing to try to do this. I'm not trying to make one company look bad, one company look good. I just want to know for myself how these devices are going to perform and what I can expect. So if I'm at a video shoot, I kind of have a good idea what my limitations are. That's what this is about. If we only share just the positive or negatives based on what we want to portray, then we're failing viewers. This here is just a non-biased. I'm not paid by Skydio or anyone. I bought this drone with my own money. So just sharing what I've seen. And I thought it was an amazing time to get out, share some awesome video with you, some awesome scenery with you. And you can see, I think there's some immersion going on that I can use for promotion work, and also some cinematic clips as well. So what do you think? Comment down below. Let me know what you think. Check out the Facebook, Skydio 2 Facebook pages. You can kind of see my short video clip there. It's about 2 minutes, 45 seconds, I believe, is what you can see as far as the attempts in the woods. Again, that was more of a commercial or teaser to set up for this video here. I think this tells more of the story. So my goal is to get this finished and edited so you all can see this and have this ready for you. So comment down below. Please like, please subscribe, and we'll talk to you soon. Thank you.